Hi, Cornerstone family. I'm sure you've heard the big news from the president as well as from our governor that we are reopening churches. Now, that's what they said. I want you to hear something right here. Cornerstone Church was never closed in the first place. In fact, we have been doing more ministry in the last 9 weeks than I can remember in the history of our church family. Your staff has been doing such a great job of moving all of our ministries and Bible studies and worship onto the line that they have put overtime in, and I just want to thank them for the wonderful job that they've been doing. 2 weeks ago, our leadership and I we put out a four-phased steps to reopening our public worship, though. And maybe you got that email a couple weeks ago. If not, you're going to find it on our website. But in that, we outline how we're going to take each step one at a time. We were in step one, phase one, and we just moved into phase two, which is beginning to meet together in small groups and our life groups and meetings here at the church and in our homes, watching worship together. And I want you to know that we are moving intentionally but slowly into our next phase, which is going to be worshiping together as a church family. It's going to be that public worship time. And can I just say, it's been way too long. I cannot wait to be together as a church family. But at the same time, I want to make sure that you hear this, that we want to do this intentionally slow so that we don't put anybody's health in peril. During these four phases in this process, we have been doing some specific things to our church to get ready for us gathering together one with one another in a way that will make sure that we don't put anybody's health at risk. Between now and the first day that we're going to get back together, which is June 14th, we will be making plans for a healthy and a safe gathering together. I can't guarantee that we're going to have a germ-free environment. We're taking every step that we can to prevent the transmission of COVID. But we are going to make every intentional way that we can to minimize any transmission. Our leadership, our staff has been working tirelessly to get us ready to get back together in worship. And on our website, you're going to find an exhaustive list of preventative guidelines and processes that we've been putting together. We're already working on them right now. And this is going to be shared over the next several weeks on our website. You're going to see it on our Facebook page, on other platforms. We're going to ask you to do this the first time we get together. It's going to be kind of like a soft reopening. We're going to try it out. To do that, we need you to help us with this. Will you please RSVP, and will you tell us that you're coming with your family and how many? What we're going to do is this. We're going to actually reserve space in the church just for you who RSVP to make sure that there's enough space and that we're doing it in an appropriate way. There's going to be a link to all the details to help us celebrate together safely. I can't give you an exhaustive list right now on the measures that we're going to take. It would be too long on this short video, but you can go to our website, or they're also going to be sent to you in your homes on an email blast in the next few days. And I just want to thank our staff once again for working incredibly long hours to bring all of our ministries together to continue to do that. I want you to know our church hasn't been closed, but what we are going to do is we're going to gather back together. I can't wait for that day. We've learned a lot through this season, and I pray that we never again take meeting together for granted. Amen. For many of us, this has been a season of recalibrating our lives, our priorities, the vision that God has given us as a church family. We know better than ever that Cornerstone is not a place that you attend. It's a church family you belong to. And putting God's kingdom first in every area of our life, we've been able to see him break out in so many wonderful ways. I'm telling you, there is a revival of God like I've never seen him in my lifetime right now. And so we want to get ready for this. And so phase three, as we move back to public worship, we're going to ask you to RSVP on the 14th, and then that'll give us a good idea of what we need to do for our re-grand opening for public worship on June 21st. So please take that chance to do that. In the coming weeks, we're going to give you some information about how we're going to do that well between now and June 14th. And so help us prepare. We're going to help us prepare for this season. And each of these four steps, in conjunction with the Riverside County Health Department and their recommendations, as well as some of the doctors in our own fellowship, we're going to move slowly. But listen to this. We're not going to move forward in fear. We're going to do it out of care for our church family. And I just want you to, I just want to share a few of the procedures that we're going to follow. Real fast, I can't list them all, but here's a few. To prevent the spread of infection, we're asking everyone to just simply wear a mask when it's possible. Now, we're not going to ask babies and children and those who aren't able to wear a mask. We're not going to ask you to do that. But where it's possible, to wear a mask. And then in our public spaces in our church, where people are going to congregate, we're going to close those areas. So we're just going to come into worship. We're going to worship, and then we're going to go home. I mean, we're just going to, that's going to be church for this phase three. The sanctuary seating is going to be spread out so that we are 6 feet apart. We're going to disinfect all the seats, all the touching areas. We're going to have hand sanitizers around the church building, and we're going to ask people to frequently wash their hands. If you have to sneeze, we're going to ask you to sneeze into your elbow, right? Just like you're supposed to do. But we're going to continue to wipe down all the surfaces in the restroom, all the touching areas to reduce any responsible, as much as we can, any area of transmission. We're not going to distribute any materials during that time, Sunday materials, bulletins, and offering. They'll just be at your seat for you. Nobody else is going to touch them. They're just going to be sitting there. And our greeters are going to be wearing masks and gloves. They're going to be giving air high fives and air hugs with big smiles. If you have any high risk because you're of your age, because of any health issues, we just want to encourage you during this phase three just to stay home, to continue to watch our live stream worship. It's going to be live at home as well. But if there's any doubt, we just ask you to stay home during this time. And while I'm looking forward to seeing everybody, I just want us to be healthy. Amen. There's a lot of attention right now on how churches and when churches are going to be opening. Here's going to be our approach. We will respect the thoughts and the decisions of others. We're not going to make anybody feel less spiritual or less faithful because they have a different approach than us. Attending church gatherings in person is not a sign that you're more mature or that you're more godly than any other person. And staying home doesn't mean that you're smarter or being safer than anybody who chooses to attend. We're just going to love each other during this season. We're going to get through it together. I promise you, we're going to get through this together. And so I just want to say thank you for loving and caring each other for the last 9 weeks. It's been an incredible season of ministry. And so let's keep this attitude of love, of caring for each other as a family, as a church family, as we go through phase three. And eventually, I'm telling you, we're going to get to phase four and have a re-grand opening of all of our ministries. And like you, I can't wait for church to come back to normal. Whatever that normal is going to look like in the next season. I know this is extra hard work, but this is only one phase. We're going to get through this together, okay? By the way, I just want you to know, there's not going to be any social distancing police at Cornerstone. We just want to encourage you to take some precautions to be safe with your health rather than just simply, following some rules. Just know that. And so until I see you in person, I want you to know I miss you. And I love you, and we're getting through this together. Amen. God bless you.